On then to qualifying three, and this first race was all about Timur Timurzianov. Of course, he ended yesterday's Q2 session in the wall. Not the same today in Q3. Out front, flat out, he set a very impressive benchmark time. Race two, bit of contact on the way down to turn one. Baumanis, like Timurzianov, really needed a clean run. He got a clout from Alex Wurz behind, who continues to learn the trade of rallycross. He's doing a good job, though, slotted into P2 in this, while the Latvian took the win. Race three, both the GCK RX machines who've had a pretty torrid weekend. Shishrit heading into the Joker. Grosjean in on the inside of Rustad. Rustad getting a little tap there from Rajalat. Later on in the race, Rajalat leading, courtesy of not having taken his Joker. Anton Markner taking it on the very first lap. He went into the lead and took the flag. On then to the quick guys, and now it all kicks off down in turn one. Andreas Backerud and Robin Larsson. A little tag, I think it was fair from Backerud. Larsson goes deep. Backerud up the inside, just holds on. You can see another bit of contact on the exit, and that fight would continue through the race. Out front, Kevin Hansen was leading for Peugeot, and come the merge, you could see that little incident in turn one had cost Backerud enough to be behind Kevin Hansen. Great drive by the young Swede. Final race of Q3, you ride on board with Solberg up towards turn one, and boom, Mattias Ekström into the side of him. Solberg doing incredibly to hold on. The stewards weren't happy with that, and Ekström was handed a 5-second penalty. Kristoffersen led Timmy Hansen up front with Sebastian Loeb in the chase as well. But look at this, Loeb forgets to joker. He misses the joker, that's a 30-second penalty. Kristoffersen comes in, Ekström super close behind him, and Timmy Hansen somehow up the inside of Solberg, who drops to the back of the pack. So it's Loeb that crosses the line first, but of course, with that penalty, it's Kristoffersen who wins Q3.